Welcome to noisesonlinetutor.com. Student, today I am going to teach you sound. First, I should teach you what is sound and its different properties. Then I will teach you different use of sound wave, and there are different physical natural phenomena which could be defined by means of this sound characteristics. And after that, I will show you different type of numerical calculation based on sound. So now I am going to start this sound. First thing is, what is sound? We know sound is nothing but energy. Yes, it is energy. Okay, sound is a form of energy. But what type of energy it is? Is it a magnetic energy? Is it a chemical energy? Is it a mechanical energy? Or any other different types of other form of energy? There are n number of form of energy. But what type of energy it is? It is one type of mechanical energy. Okay. We know energy neither create nor destroy. That means we cannot create energy or we cannot destroy energy. Only we could change the form of the energy. That means if sound is energy, as I have already told you, sound is energy, then that means it will transfer from one form to another form. That means sound energy should be converted to another form of energy, or another form of energy will produce sound as a form of other form of energy. Okay, like when bomb explode, chemical energy converted to sound energy, and that will destroy window glasses due to the mechanical form of energy. I have already told, when bomb explode, let this is a bomb, when it explode, it will create a sound wave, and that wave will travel in different direction, and that will give a mechanical force on the glass. Let this is the glass. Then as glass is a brittle material, and then this will break. So here first chemical energy of the bomb converted to sound energy, and that sound energy due to its mechanical form of energy destroy the glasses. Okay, now what sound does? It produces a sensation of hearing in our ears. That means we could hear sound because it is a form of energy. Okay, at the end of the slide, I will discuss how we could hear the sound. Okay, now production of sound energy. By means of what we could produce sound energy? There are different ways of producing a sound, but for our cases, that means according to our syllabus, we should concentrate on tuning fork. What is tuning fork? Why we should use tuning fork? See, this is a picture of a tuning fork. It's a U-shaped instrument. Here marking is you will find on the surface of the tuning fork, and that will emboss to give the instruction about the frequency which could be generated by this tuning fork. There are so many ways to produce sound. Tuning fork is an instrument which vibrates at a specified frequency embossed on it. That means here in this picture it is mentioned as 659. Okay, 659 means this tuning fork could be vibrate and create a sound wave which will have frequency of 659 hertz. Now any medium due to vibration will produce sound. Yes, any medium could produce sound, because if you if you give a force or blow on a metal plate, then it will create a sound. If you blow a stick on the surface of the water, then it will also create a sound, right? Vibration is essential for sounds as it's a mechanical energy. As I have already told that vibration is the essential part of the producing a sound. Without vibration, sound will never produce. Okay, by means of vibration, that means it's a form of mechanical form of energy, sound energy will produce. Now, whether force required to produce the sound? When a table tennis ball hit tuning fork, it's applied force on the fork that vibrate the tuning fork. Due to vibration, it produces sound. See, in this picture, there is a tennis ball which hang by a thread and it just touch the tuning fork. When I shift this ball from this point to this point, that means this is the distance x, due to the shifting of this, the this much of center displace, center of the bob displace this much, that means let this is y. Due to the change of this position, it gains some potential energy, and this potential energy will give a force on the tuning fork, and due to this force it vibrates, okay, and that will create sound. If we transfer the fork into a water filled glass, then the vibration will transfer energy to water and glass. Now both will vibrate but in different frequencies and will produce sound due to vibration. See this picture. Here this tuning fork is shifted to here inside a water filled glass. Due to its vibration, this will also give force on water, and that will vibrate according to the force transfer from tuning fork to the water, and that will also vibrate. Okay, that means force is always required to produce sound. Now, what is vibration? It's a kind of rapid to and fro motion. That means if it is a point and it rapidly move left and right direction, then I will tell it's a vibration. Vibration means this body will move like this. Okay. Now, sound of the human voice box produces due to vibration only. Yes, as I am giving you a lecture, during this lecture actually I am vibrating my voice box filament or membrane. That membrane, due to vibration, creating sounds of different frequencies, and that is recording by this electronic instrument. Okay. Now, sound travel through the medium by means of vibration. I will discuss this later. And vibration requires force to produce. Scratching, rubbing also produce vibration, so it also able to generate sound. See, this is the picture. Here, a tuning fork. First, tuning fork B was vibrating with a specific frequencies. This vibration, due to vibration, a wave is transferred from this tuning fork to fork A, and that will get a repeated force by means of sound waves. Due to repeated force, this tuning fork also vibrating with another frequencies as per its own design, and that will also vibrate. Okay, so that means this sound energy produced by tuning fork B is transferred through the media and it is acting on tuning fork A. Okay, and then tuning fork also, tuning fork A also vibrating according to its frequencies. Now, how propagation of sound takes place? How it's happen? See, whenever a loudspeaker creating sound, that sound will reach up to our ears, and by means of our organ or our organic mechanism, we could hear the sound. See, first, sound required a medium to travel. Yes, sound required a medium to travel. Here, air is the medium, right? It can travel through solid, liquid, and gases. When an object vibrates, it sets the particles of the medium around it vibrating. The particle of the medium does not travel. Only energy transfer from one point to another point by vibration of particles. First, the particle of the medium is contact with the vibrating object will displaced from its equilibrium position and exerts a force on the adjacent particles. The adjacent particles displaced from its position of rest and transfer sound energy to next particle. The process continues and reaches sound energy to our ears. This sound energy we could able to hear due to mechanism of our ear. That means whenever the loudspeaker is creating sound, its membrane is vibrating in this form, and here air particles are there. These air particles will get the force, and due to that the particles will compressed here. Whenever that sound wave passed away, then these particles will get relaxed and will produce this form. Okay, by means of continuous compression and expansion, the sound wave will pass from loudspeaker to up to our ear. This peak and this hill and dip indicates the maximum intensity of energy and minimum intensity of energy in between these two zones. Okay. Now, how sound travel through ear? Sound travel through ear by compression and expansion of air particles. What, as I have already told you, see here. When our sound wave pass through the ear, this ear first compress, then expand, then again compress, then again expand. During the expansion, compression, the air particles are nearer to each other, and during the expansion, the air particles are away from each other. And then, by means of this compression and expansion, sound wave pass through the air. See here, when a vibrating object moves forward, it pushes and compresses the air in front of it and creating a region of compression. See, here it is the region of compression, right? Here also you can see, whenever this is vibrating, here a compression zone is produced. Then when this energy transfer to this point, that means here to here, then here the particles are compressed and here it will expand. Okay, the compression starts to move away from the vibrating object. When the vibrating object moves backward, it creates a region of low pressure which is called rarefaction or expansion. This is called rarefaction or this or expansion. Okay, now as the object moves back and forth rapidly, a series of compression and expansion is created in the air. this make the sound wave to propagate. So by means of expansion, compression, the sound wave will move through the air. Now, sound needs a medium to travel. Whether sound needs a medium to travel? Yes, it is required a medium to travel. See this test. Take an electric bulb and an airtight glass bell jar. Here it is a picture. This is a jar which is airtight, and here a vacuum pump is connected. Air will suck through this point. Okay, and there is a bell here within the jar. The bell jar is connected to a vacuum pump. As I already told, without starting vacuum pump, first switch on the bell and hear the sound. Without starting the vacuum pump, first whenever we connect the circuit, we complete the circuit, the bell will ring. Due to ring, it will create a vibration within the air particle inside the jar, and that will act on the surface of the jar, and that will transfer the energy to outside air particles, and we could hear the sound. Here we could hear the sound. Okay, now start vacuum pump and keep switch on the bell. You will find that sound become fainter at a certain time. Sound will disappear though the bell is switched on. Due to non presence of air particles and mechanical nature of sound wave, it can't travel inside the jar. Whenever I start vacuum pump, that time the air particle will goes out from the jar, and after a certain time no air particle will remain within the jar, which could transfer the sound energy from this point to the surface of the jar. So it is proved that sound required a medium to travel. Okay, again, if I again pump back air inside the jar, and that time if I complete the circuit of the bell, then I could hear the sound energy continuously coming from the jar, and its intensity is increasing slowly. Okay, due to presence of air particles again inside the jar. Now, what are the types of sound? There are three different categories of sound as per frequency range. One is infrasonic sound. Here frequency range is 0 to 20. Audible sound. Here frequency range is 20 to 20,000. This audible means it is audible to human beings. This audible means it is audible to human beings only. And ultrasonic sound. Its frequency range is more than 20,000 Hertz. Hertz is the unit of the frequency. Human being can't hear the range, hear this infrasonic sound. Rhino, whales, elephants could produce and hear this type of sound. Human being could only hear the sound between 20 to 20,000 Hertz. That's why it is called audible sound. Human beings can't also hear ultrasonic sound. Some insects like moth and dogs could hear this sound. Ultrasonic machines are used this sound for navigation of imaging purpose. I will discuss details about ultrasonic machines after some slides. Okay. Now, type of sound waves. There are two types of sound waves: longitudinal sound wave and transverse sound waves. Sound waves are longitudinal in gaseous and liquid medium. See, sound waves are longitudinal in gaseous and liquid medium. In these waves, the individual particle of the medium move in a direction parallel to the direction of the propagation of disturbance. That means, in case of longitudinal wave, the particle of the medium will move right to left, and sound wave also pass from right to left. That means they are parallel to each other. This is called longitudinal wave. This particle do not move one place to another place, but simply oscillate to and fro from this position. That means any point, let this is a point, if it vibrate, then it will vibrate to and fro, but this particle at the end of the transfer of the sound energy will not transfer from this place to this place. Okay, it will be here only. In a transverse waves, particle do not oscillate along the line of wave propagation, but oscillate up and down above their mean position. That means here the particles are oscillate up and down, but sound wave passing in this direction, so they are not parallel. So this type of sound wave is called transverse wave, right? Light is a transverse wave. Sound also transfer through a solid and liquid as transverse wave. Remind this. Sound also transfer through solid and liquid as transverse wave, but for gaseous and liquid it will pass as longitudinal wave. That means sound cannot pass as longitudinal wave through solids. Okay. Transverse wave has polarization property, but sound wave does not have such property. This is a property or a difference between the transverse wave and longitudinal wave, and you could learn about this in class 12. Okay. Now, characteristics of sound wave. Characteristics of sound wave described by three following things: frequency, amplitude, and speed. First, what is frequency? It is the number of waveform per unit time due to vibration. That means by vibration of any medium, sound will produce, and that number of vibration per unit time is called the frequency. Or we could say number of complete oscillations takes place per unit time, also called a frequency. Or it could be defined as number of compression or expansion takes place per unit time. This is for the gaseous medium basically, because I have already told that sound wave pass through the medium by means of compression and expansion. Okay. Frequency is equal to 1 by wavelength, and its unit is hertz. Now, amplitude. It is the magnitude of the maximum disturbance in the medium on either side of the mean value. Its unit is in meter. See this picture, right? Here, amplitude here here this is a picture of a sound wave. Okay, this is a picture of sound wave, and this is the mean position of the medium. Or here it is called the magnitude of maximum disturbance in the medium on either side of the mean value. This is the mean value. Its maximum disturbance is this much. So this is called amplitude of the sound wave. Okay, and its unit is meter. That means distance between this point to this point will we call as amplitude. Okay, now velocity. It is the distance traveled by sound per unit time, as normal as another particle. Okay, and units is as usual meter per second. Velocity is equal to frequency into wavelength. Details of sound wave form. See, it is a sound wave. This is a sound wave. Here it is called amplitude, and this is called crest, this is throw, and this is called the wavelength. Here it is the defined for longitudinal wave. The distance between compression and expansion is called the distance between two consecutive compression is called wavelength, or we could say the distance between two consecutive expansion also as a wavelength, and this is the amplitude of the sound wave. See, time period. The time period is, it is the time taken by two consecutive compression or expansion to cross a fixed point. Okay, time period means, it is the time taken by two consecutive compression or expansion. That means, let any time sound wave is here, and that sound wave pass from this point to another consecutive point, let here, to transfer from this point to this point, the time required is called time period. Or it is the time taken for one complete oscillation in the density of the medium. That means this is the one complete oscillation. Okay, so from this point to this point, the time required is called the time period. It is represented by T, and its SI unit is second, as usual at time. Crest, it is a peak of sinusoidal curve. This is crest, and throw, this is the valley of sinusoidal curve. This is called sinusoidal curve. This type of curve is called sinusoidal curve. Okay, now wavelength, the distance between two consecutive compression or expansion is called wavelength, as I have already told you, and it is represented by lambda, and its unit is meter. Now pitch of sound wave. What is the meaning of pitch? See, here two sound waves are drawn. In this sound wave, there are two sound wave. Let this is the time required to travel by the sound. This is for 1 second. Then within 1 second, only two sound wave pass within two consecutive point. And in this case, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Approximately 7.5 sound wave pass through this, meaning through these two consecutive points. So, what is pitch? It is one of the characteristics of sound by means of which we could differentiate source of sound which have same speed and medium to travel. It perceived as low, as how low or high a sound is, and represents represents the cyclic repetitive nature of vibration. It is how brain is intercepts the frequency of an emitted sound. Pitch depends in the frequency of the sound. The sound is of whistle has a high pitch, and sound of thunder has a low pitch. That means here the frequency of the sound wave was only 2, but here it is 7.5. Both the sound take same time to travel same distance. That means their velocity are same, and they are traveling in the same medium. But what is their difference? The basic difference is only the frequency. Due to this difference in frequency, we could check our brain could intercepts what is the source from which that sound is producing. That means let whistle, or we could say there are two container. One is filled with water, and another one is big container. It is also filled with water, but open, and it is filled with water, and it is creating a sound wave of 20 hertz, and it is creating a sound wave of 250 hertz. Then brain can intercepts the which instruments or which body is creating the sound, though there everything is different. Everything is same, the medium is same, they are creating the same sound wave in the air, and their velocity is same, but their basic difference is their frequency is different. So by means of this difference, brain could intercept the frequency, and it could differentiate the source of the sound. That is called pitch. How we could differentiate between sound producers in violin and flute? See, the sound producers in two different instruments have same velocity, but frequencies are different. Brain could differentiate these frequencies based on the personal experience of sound pattern. Okay, why pitch of girls or ladies is more than men? The vocal membrane of the females are not getting stiff due to age, but men's vocal membrane gets stiff with age. That means our vocal membrane stiff. This is the vocal membrane, and here this membrane will getting stiff. Then it will creates a sound wave of less frequencies. But in case of girls and ladies, this membrane is not that much stiff, or its stiffness will not change normally. That's why it will create sound wave of high frequencies. So the girls and ladies will have the sound waves of high frequencies, so their pitch is high compared to men. Here, see, there is a thunder picture. Here, the sound wave is generated is created within the ear, and also a mouse also creating a sound which is also passing through the ear, and both the cases have same velocity of the sound. But here, the sound wave has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hertz. Let this is the time required for 1 second. Then here the frequencies is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. That means it has 14 hertz. So the frequency of the sound wave produces by the mouse is more. That's why, though they have the same type of sound wave, but brain could differentiate between the lightning sound and the sound produced by the mouse due to the high pitch of mouse sound wave produced by mouse. Loudness of sound wave. The loudness or softness of sound wave is determined basically its amplitude. The amplitude of the sound wave depends upon the force with which an object is made to vibrate. That means, see this picture here. Let this is the time up to here, it is equal to 1 second, and this is also 1 second required. Okay, and both the cases sound wave has same velocity, as their consecutive point different distance is same. So here you could see the difference between the amplitude of those two sounds. Here the sound wave has, let this is x, this is y, where x is very very greater than y. That means amplitude of the second sound wave is much more greater than first one. That's why the loudness, that means the total energy which is pinging on our ear drum, is more in case of second. So that's why its loudness is more. In the given picture, the both the sound wave have same frequency and same speed, but loudness of the second wave is high compared to first due to higher amplitude of the wave. This is the higher amplitude. Okay. Between a tiger roar and peacock shrill of same frequency, which have more loudness and why? See, the amplitude of roaring sound is much more than shrill of so sound. Loudness of roaring sound is more. Louder sound can travel a large distance as it associated with the higher energy, right? Comparing loudness and pitch. Here in this picture, the amplitude is more compared to this. So this sound wave will have high loudness, but in this cases the sound wave is having one frequency is 1, and here it is 1, 2, 3, 4. So the pitch of this sound wave will be more because it is depends on the number of frequencies. Now difference between loudness and intensity. Intensity, it is the amount of energy passing through unit area each sound. There is a misunderstanding between interchangeability between intensity and loudness of the sound. Loudness is measured by response of ear due to amplitude variation even with same intensity of sound. See, here in this case I want to say that means this is a speaker and it's creating sound. Okay, if per unit area the energy transfer due to the sound is more, then I will say the intensity of the sound is more, but that will not related to the amplitude of the sound wave. That means if the sound wave is like this or like this, it does not matter, because the intensity of sound wave is the total energy passed through per unit area. It does not depends on the amplitude of the sound wave. Okay, speed of sound. Speed, it is defined as the distance between two consecutive point of same phase, that is compression or expansion on a wave travels per unit time. Speed equal to distance by time. It is normal as per particle. Okay, and frequency, that is normally indicated as n. Okay, according to Newton's law, the velocity of sound is equal to under root p by rho, where p is the pressure and rho is the density of the medium. And according to Laplace, it will become under root gamma p by rho, where k is the and it is nothing but under root k by rho, where k is the elastic bulk modulus and rho is the density of the medium. Speed of sound in air at 20 degrees Celsius is 346 meter per second, and in water it is 1498, that means 1498 meter per second. It may vary if salt content is increased. Speed of sound in steel is 5960 meter per second. Reflection of sound, it is the bouncing of sound wave from a reflector. Sound wave require large size of reflector for reflection compared to light wave. Light wave, due to its large size of wavelength. See, sound waves are, if sound waves are in this size, then light waves are this size. Their wavelength are so less that it could reflect from a very small or narrow surface, but this required a large surface to reflect. Reflection of sound wave follows law of reflection as same as light. Here you could see, as per law of reflection, the angle of incident angle equal to angle of reflection, that means I equal to R, and the incident ray, that means the incident sound wave, reflected sound wave, and the normal at that point should be lie on the same plane. Here it is on the same plane. Law 1, the directions in which the sound is incident and the reflected and is reflected makes equal angle with the normal to the reflecting surfaces. That means here I equal to R, I equal to R. And second law, the incident sound wave, this one, the reflected sound wave, and the normal at the incident point, this is the normal at the incident point, will have on the same plane. Echo. What is echo? It is the repeated hearing of a sound wave after creation due to reflection. See, if you assume that this red color band indicate the mother sound, then after traveling a certain distance, it will come back with blue color sound wave. So this is called echo. Whether echo will create any difference between the source and the reflector? No. See, human being can hear a sound wave if it is present inside our ear minimum 1/10 seconds. That means to hear the one syllable sound wave echo, that sound should persist in ear minimum 0.1 second. As speed of the sound wave in ear is about 334 meters per second at 0 degrees Celsius, so during this time, that means 0.1 second, that sound wave should go up to the reflector surface and come back to ear again to hear the repeated sound wave. That means sound required to go from this point to this point, and again it will come back up to the ear of the observer. So within 1/10 second it will travel this two distance. That means it should travel 33.4 meter distance. Okay, so the minimum distance required to hear the echo will be half, because it will go in this direction and it will go back the same distance opposite direction. So it is equal to 16.7. if you take defined value of the velocity, then this value will change, but it is approximately 17 meter, which is required to hear single syllable sound waves echo. Or if it is two syllable sound wave, then it become 2 × 17 meters, that is equal to 34 meters, is required the distance between the source and the reflector. Okay, reverberation. What is reverberation? Whether it is same as echo? No, it is not same as echo. When a sound in a big hall is created, it will persist by repeated reflection from the walls until it is reduced to a value where it is no longer audible due to lower range of frequency, is called reverberation. It happens due to repeated reflection of sound wave and big size of hall. It is defined from echo. Echo heard after a certain time, one after another, which is with a specific time interval, but in case of reverberation it will appear in ear randomly to random reflection as shown in figure. See this figure. If a person sitting inside a big hall and a sound creates, then it will come back to the observer from different direction at random manner. That means that person will hear the sound from different direction in random manner. But in case of echo, the sound wave should travel a minimum distance, then it will create the next sound, presence of sound in the ear. That means it takes a specific time to reach up to the observer, and it will come back to the observer in a specific direction. But in case of reverberation, it will be random. That means it will come from all direction. Okay, this is the specific difference between reverberation and echo. Reverberation could be reduced by applying sound absorbing material such as compressed fiber board, rough plaster, draperies, etc. And these are already used inside the theater hall, where sound wave should be should not produce any reverberation, because then that will disturb the audience to hear the movies, which is not a good thing for watching the movies, right? So the inside the theater, compressed fiber boards are used to absorb that unwanted sound waves, which should not be there, and that should not be produced inside the theater. Use of multiple reflection of sound. See, echolocation. It is a sound, it is a word which is required to learn, because echoes are used to find object underwater, and that is called echolocation. And multiple reflection also used for different instrument. I will discuss this here. First thing is megaphone, soundboard, horns, stethoscope, sonar uses reflection properties of sound wave. In megaphones, soundboards, horns, due to conical opening, sound reflects successively to guide most of the sound waves from the source to the in the forward direction towards the audience, as shown in figure. See this figure here. It is a picture of a sound wave. This is a picture of soundboard. Here sound is produced here, and sound after reflection getting a specific direction to flow. That means we could reflect sound successively to most guide the sound waves from the source to the forward direction towards the audience. That means audience should be here, and audience should easily hear the sound which is creating at this point. Okay, by using this soundboard, we could direct the sound wave to the audience. That will never go other direction other than which we require to send. Now, how does stethoscope work? See, it's a picture of stethoscope. This is a tube. Within the tube, the heartbeat sound will continuously reflected in this direction, and that will appear up to the this point, and the doctor will hear the heartbeat of the patients, and by that way the doctor could check the condition of this patient. See, the stethoscope is a medical instrument which is used to listening to sound produced within the body. In stethoscope, the sound of the heartbeat reaches the doctor's ears by multiple reflection as shown in figure. Why does old conference hall ceiling was made curved rather than plain? See, that time our electronic instruments are not developed so much, so the person who is going to give lecture, his sound should appear to all point of the within the hall. So the ceiling of the lecture hall made curved by by due to this curved shape, the sound wave could travel to different location within the room, and that is helpful for the lecturer, so that he could easily reach up to the all the viewers. Otherwise, this lectures required to speak in louder way, and that is not helpful for the lecturer, right? See, the ceiling of the old cinema's conference halls was made curved so that the sound wave sound after reflection could reaches all the corners of the walls of the halls, as shown in the figure. Sometimes it also have the curved soundboard behind the stages. That means this here also curved soundboard, then sound wave will pass in this direction. Okay, some of the soundboard it could easily spread evenly across the hall. Now, application of ultrasound. Ultrasound are very high frequency sounds. This frequency is more than 20,000 hertz. It could not hear by human beings. Human beings could not hear this type of sound. Its frequency range is greater than 20 kilohertz. I have already told. These sound waves are used extensively in industries and for medical purpose. Ultrasonic are generally used to clean parts located in hard to reach places, such as spiral tube, odd shaped parts, electronic component, etc. Ultrasound waves are made to reflect from various parts of the heart and form the image of the heart. This is called echocardiography. How ultrasound cleaning carried out? Object to be cleaned are placed in a cleaning solution, and ultrasound are sent into the solution. Due to higher frequency, the particles, dust, grease get detached from and dropped out. By this method, the object get clean. Okay. How ultrasonic used to detect cracks and flaws in metal blocks? See, let this is a metal block which having some cracks here. Okay, if ultrasound is produced, and here this ultrasound is produced, and it is the detector which will receive the sound wave which is generated from this point, and if it is uniform, then sound wave will easily pass through the metal block and will intercept by the detector. But if any cracks is there, then here it will get another surface to reflect. That time sound wave will never reach up to this detector. It will come back due to reflection. So by means of non-detection of this detector, we could easily assume that there is a deficiency within the metal block. Okay. See here, the metallic components which are used in construction of high rise buildings, bridge, machines should be free from internal cracks and flaws to get reliability. As these cracks and holes are inside the metal block, so these are invisible from outside. As it is made of metal, so from outside we could not see inside the metal. Okay. Ultrasonic waves are allowed to pass through the metal blocks, and detectors are used to detect and transmit the waves. If there is a defect, the ultrasonic sound gets deflected, or I could say it is reflected back, which indicates flaws of or defects present inside the metal block. Here is a picture of ultrasonography of a pregnant lady. Application of ultrasound. How ultrasound creates image? The ultrasonography, it's a picture of ultrasonography. Here you could see a picture of a baby. It is a picture of a baby, right? The ultrasonography is used to getting image of internal organs. It is the body of within the organ, or it is a human body within a body, or we could make another picture of human body organ also, like gallbladder, uterus, kidney, etc. It helps the doctor to check the abnormalities. Here the ultrasound waves are travel through the tissues of the body and get deflected from the region where there is a change of tissue density. See, the baby will within the body inside a fluid ball, and when sound is passing through this medium, here the sound wave will get reflected back, because the sound wave will change due to the change in density of the within the body and the fluid. Okay, these waves are then converted into electrical signal that are used to generate image of the organ. This image are then displayed on the monitor, the analysis to analyze the problem, right? So by means of ultrasonic waves of sound, we could create the image of the organs or the babies. Sonar means sound navigation and ranging system. Okay, it is an instrument to measure the distance, direction and speed of underwater object. It consists of transmitter and a detector. See, here is the picture. Here it is a transmitter and it is a detector. Actually, both are located in the same position. The sound wave generated by the transmitter will transmit to the up to the surface of the seabed, and it will come back to the detector. It will receive, and there is a time difference. Time difference is t, and sound wave velocity within the water is v, then total time distance travel v travel by the sound wave is equal to v into t. As it will travel up to the seabed and it come back to the again to the same place, then the total height equal to height or distance equal to vt by 2. So by means of this, it could navigate its position from the seabed, right? See, here the function is written. It first produces and transmit ultrasonic waves. These waves are traveled through water, and after striking the object on the sea bed, get reflected back and sensed by the detector. Here it is reflected and sent back by detector. Okay. When the detector converts the ultrasound wave of an electrical signal which the appropriately intercepted, if the timetable between the transmission and reception of the sound wave become t and velocity of the sound wave within the medium is v, then total distance traveled by the sound wave is vt, which is vt. Okay, this is equal to the total distance 2d. This sound wave will come from this point to this point, and then again it will come back to this point. So it is 2D. By equating that, we could get D. This is the way to check the depth of distance of the object. Okay. The method is called eco-ranging or echolocation. Human ear. See, it is a picture of human ear. This human ear has three parts: outer ear, middle ear and inner ear. Outer ear is called pinna. This is pinna. This part is called pinna. Okay, it collects the sound from the surrounding. That means sound wave will come from different direction. It will collect the sound, and elephants has the biggest size of pinna. Okay. The collected sound passes through the auditory canal. This is called auditory canal, and at the end of the auditory canal there is a thin membrane. When a compression of the medium reaches the eardrum, the pressure on the outside of the membrane increases and forces the eardrum inwards. That means here it will create a force, so it will go inside. The eardrum will get inward. The eardrum moves outward when a expansion part of the wave reaches It means there are three bones are here. In this way the eardrum vibrates. The vibrations are amplified by several times by three bones. Those are hammer, anvil and stirrup. There are three bones: hammer, anvil and stirrup. And in the middle ear, this is the part of middle ear. Okay, middle ear. This amplified pressure vibrates receives from the sound wave to the inner ear. This is called cochlea. And this cochlea, within the cochlea, that sound wave converted to electrical signals. Here within the cochlea there is a liquid, and that will convert the electrical, the mechanical sound wave to electrical signals, and that will send to the brain. That sound intercept by the brain accordingly. Okay, so by means of this, the human ear could hear the sound wave which is coming from the outside. So this is all about the sound and its different properties and its different use. I will teach different numericals based on sound after this video, and I think you people could understand the different properties of sound and its and different uses. If you have any doubt, then you could log on to the website and you could ask your question through this website. Thank you.